Hi friends, welcome to Tutors Funny channel. In our last tutorial, we saw how to display the auto increment ID like this. In this tutorial, I am going to teach how to add the records one by one. Okay. If I fill this form and click OK button, the record is added into our database tables. After that, after adding this record into the database table, this new ID will be generated here, 0002. Okay. Well, let me see how to do that. Right. Now, double click on this OK button. I am going to write the coding inside this button here, this one. Here what I am going to do is here, I am going to write the try block. Try and catch. Right. Here what I am going to write here is, I am going to write the query, insert query first. So I already wrote the variable above. What query here, what I am going to do is here, query equal, here I am going to write as, I am going to insert the record, so insert into which table I am going to insert the record. You have to specify the table name here, which table, record is the table name, you have to write correct name. Okay, without spelling mistakes. After that, you have to add the column names here inside the bracket. Okay, what are the columns? Product ID, product name. Okay, here what I am going to do is here, I am going to copy this one, product ID, just copy, Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste here, comma. Again go here, back to your database table, Ctrl C to copy, back to your form, paste, do so on. If you do like this, you can avoid the errors, spelling errors. Okay, what you wrote here is same thing you have to wrote here, so that if you copy and paste, you can avoid the spelling mistake. Okay, now you have successfully wrote the columns here. After that, I am going to add the form values here. Open curly bracket and close curly bracket here. Okay, values I am going to add like this. Single quotation, double quotation, double quotation, single quotation. Okay, you have to remember this one. It's very must. Okay, single quotation, double quotation, here single quotation, double quotation, double quotation, single quotation. Okay, within here you have to write this and signs marks. Here you have to write the text box fields. Here I am going to write text box 1, text box 2, text box 3, text box 4. If you like, you can change the name as TXT product ID, TXT product name, TXT product description and price. If you want, you can do this. Okay, I just do the as a default. So text box 1 mean by text ID. Right. After that, same thing I am going to write here is comma. Right. What? After that, we have to copy same thing here, copy this one and paste. After the comma, Ctrl V to paste, otherwise you just right click and paste. Okay, the same thing here, you have to change the name of the text box as TX text box 2. After that comma, the same code you have to paste. Okay, I already copied here. You must copy this one. You have to select this one, single quotation from this this single quotation. Okay, you must select like this. Okay, after that you have to paste here 3, text box 3, the final one is comma, text box 4. Right, we successfully put right. Now what I am going to do is, there is no error. Now what I am going to do is here, after that I successfully wrote the queries, after that I am going to establish the connection. So what is the connection object here? Connection DB, this one, this database connection I am going to give to this database connection. I am going to give to this insert query here. So we have to put the connection here. We have to establish the connection here. After that we have to test cmd equal new SQL command. It is just that the queries and connection both are correct or not. That is the meaning of SQL command. Okay, if it is both correct, it should work. So first write a query. First this query variable first. After that you have to write as a connection. This connection con. This con connection will be, it is inside this connection function. It is inside this connection function. Here this one. This one. Okay. It is inside this function. Okay. If you put here, you will able to get this one inside here. Okay. After that, simply we have to execute the query. How to execute? Cmd dot execute not query. This method will be execute command. If you call this one, the record will be successfully added into your database table. That's the only thing you have to do. After that, I'm going to put the message box. You have to write the message box like this, otherwise you can write easily message box in vb.net. Message box like this, it is easy one. Sorry, here, right, here you have to write success message. Right, that's the only thing you have to do. Okay, that's the only thing you have to do. After that, if there is any error, you can write like this ex.message. Okay, let's see whether it's working or not. If you execute the query, right. Now we have to fill the blank. Product ID fan. Product fan only. Try something like that. Click OK. Right. Record success. Success. If you got the message as success, record is added into your database table. Let me check whether it's working or not. This is the table. You just right click on this one and select top under the rows. This one, so select this, so select that one. If it is success, see this one here. The record is successfully added into your database table. Product ID 1. Product ID 1 means this one here. This 30, this is ignoring, so that here 1 will be displayed. Okay. Right. Now what I am going to do is here, after insert the record, the text box record has been cleared. After insert the record, the text box field, all the text box fields are clear, and the newly auto increment ID will be generated on the text box ID text box. Okay. Okay, let's see how it goes. Right. So what I'm going to do is here, simply we have to clear the text box 1 dot clear. If you call the function clear, you will be able to clear. Otherwise there will be another port. So to clear text equal this one, you can write either this or that. Okay, both are same. Right, I am writing this one. This one I like. Okay, I copy, Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste, Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste. We have to change the name of the text box, whichever text box we have to change, right. After that, what I am going to do is here, I am clear all the stuff. After that, this is the form load, the form load event. I call this method, which method? Get in product ID. Okay, when the form is loaded, this method will be loaded. That's why the auto increment ID will be displayed here. Okay, so once you click add the records, the record has been added into database table. You can get the message successfully once added into database table. After that, clear all the columns. After that, the newly created, newly increment ID will be increment ID will be displayed. Okay, after clear all the text box, newly created ID will be displayed. After that, what I am going to do is here, the cursor will be pointing on text box 2. The cursor will be focus on product name text box here, focus on, okay. New ID has been created, cursor will be focus on here. What is the new product name you are typing? It is asked. That's why here focus. So that is the efficient way to write the program. So let me see that one also. So this is stuff, text box 2, it is belongs to product name. Here you have to write the method as focus, right? That's the only thing you have to do, right? Now let me click here. Now if you write the product name as TV, here TV only, something like that. I am going to write the description here. Price is write as like this. Click success. Here successfully it's working. It's focus on the product text box here. Newly generated ID will be coming here. Okay. Now here you can notice that here you can able to change the ID. Okay. This is not efficient. Okay. So that what I am going to do is here, you have to read only. You have to select this one and change it as a properties. Go to the properties here. Here you have to select as a read only. Here read only you have to put as a true. Okay, now you have to, here you have to start, click start. Here you can read only, you can read only, you can't do anything else, you can read only. I hope you guys you enjoy my tutorial. If you like my channel, please subscribe me, like me. Thank you for watching.